We're just pulling up to the coast of Gulf Shores, Alabama. Because this blimp just glides across the water, these guys have a great viewpoint. And when they spot anything wrong, they tell the pilots, who then radio down to that vessel right there. Rob Marciano's on that.
And we are on the lead strike team vessel that's heading out into the Gulf of Mexico to work with 10 other vessels of opportunities that are skimming out there. And that that blimp, that's going to help recon with us. It's going to be quite an experience. Lieutenant J.G. Scott McBride with me on the command vessel here. You were just on the horn getting some information. What can you tell us?
Basically, what's happening here is the airship is conducting its search pattern. It's flying approximately 22 knots. And what's going to happen is it flies at 1,000 feet. Once it spots oil, it's going to descend to 500 feet to get a closer look.
Webb, where are we headed right now?
We're actually going in. Some skimmers had a report of medium to light oil. So we're actually going to go there and find it. These guys are picking up oil right here, these skimmers.
There's a little light sheen reported on the water. And these guys, along with the strike team behind us, they actually cleaned it up.
Taking a look right now, it's some boom. There's a boat down there laying that to protect the beautiful white sands of Gulf Shores, Alabama. They even have a book that shows pictures of exactly what they're looking for. And there's names for all these kinds of oil. You got medium oil there, light oil. We even have what's called a streamer.
Roger that. If y'all are through with the booming here, we were going to continue westbound about a half mile offshore and meet up eventually with the Fort Morgan group.
All right, copy that.
The workhorse of the Coast Guard search and rescue operations, and Steve Sorg, one of our photojournalists, is hopping a ride with them to give us yet another vantage point of how all this is coming together.
I think what's most evident about the effects of this oil spill on the coastline is look at these beaches. Normally they're packed with tourists, and you're just seeing empty lawn chairs and umbrellas.
You're going to see a lot of sharks that are pushed up. What's happening is the bait fish are coming closer to shore because of all the oil. So all the sharks, I mean, we've seen pods of 100 plus sharks at one time. I've never seen that in my entire life.
The latest weapon in the arsenal to battle this oil spill there is the airship heading back now to land. Seas here are getting way too rough to do any sort of effective skimming. So at least for today, skimming operations have ended.
We just wrapped up day 12 of testing this blimp. There's about 2 weeks left, and then the Coast Guard will decide if they want to send this out in the field to hunt for oil permanently.